Over the past fortnight, we've been looking at how to stop these crimes from happening. In the fifth part of his series on preventing youth crime, John Campbell meets a young offender who's turned her life around, giving a striking answer when John asked how she did it.
If these are young offenders, the terrible probability is they've offended before and they're statistically likely to offend again. Those who manage to stop themselves are few and almost miraculous. Why are you in here?
Because I offended.
In 2018, I met a 17-year-old offender in a youth prison. Aggravated robberies, repeatedly stealing cars. And how long have you been in here for?
I'm going on my 8th month.
This was for RNZ's Checkpoint program 4 years ago. But like all the young people in our series of the past fortnight, her childhood had been routinely violent.
My dad just used to beat me, my siblings and my mum, just for no reason at all.
And then they end up here, some of them almost broken beyond hope. What dreams have they been left with other than surviving?
But I have a sense, and I don't want to put words in your mouth, that you're hoping for more than that now.
Yeah, I'm hoping to get out and change my life and not... I want to be a beauty therapist.
A beauty therapist. That was 2018. And this, wait for it, is now. Meet Naya Bishop, makeup artist.
I've gotten my level 3 and level 4 qualification for makeup artistry.
The question is, how did she do it? Because most youth offenders end up in adult prison. How did a girl who did ugly become a woman who does beautiful?
My goal was just to get out and stay out. That was the first goal.
She heard about the makeup course, applied and was accepted. But even turning up was something new and remarkable.
Because I didn't do good at school. I used to wag and all of that stuff. And even just to come into a course and actually be welcomed somewhere where I fit because I liked it, because I had a passion for it, that's where it started.
When she arrived, she was wearing an ankle bracelet to monitor her. She had no idea whether they'd accept her, whether she could escape the weight of her past.
There was just a lot of anger towards not even just my dad, just heaps of people. And they, you know, some of those people didn't even do anything to me, but it was just the anger in me, it was the hurt.
Oh my gosh!
Sometimes we beat the odds. Sepoila and Gemma are youth workers at Te Aorere a Te Tonga. The gifts are from staff there for Naya's baby. The baby's dad is another former youth offender. He's concreting and bricklaying. He too is making it in the world. It's such a long way from here, where Naya, age 17, suddenly understood what she needed to break the cycle.
It's the forgiveness. Yeah. It's hard. It's hard to forgive. But you just got to find it in you to forgive those who hurt you and those that done wrong to you. And you also have to forgive yourself as well. So that played a big part in where I am today.
And now your job is making people beautiful.
Yeah.